Welcome to my channel Dharma Voice. Before we get into the video, make sure to press subscribe button and bell icon so that you will get notification whenever I upload new videos. Let's look into today's video. Hi, today I'm going to tell you what is eczema and what are the types of eczema. Eczema is basically inflammation of the skin. In dermatology, we call it as dermatitis. It is characterized by red skin rash associated with itching, irritation, or even burning sensation. In the beginning, it may be associated with oozing. Oozing means water will be coming from these rash. But later, skin become thick and black. We broadly classify into exogenous and endogenous eczema. Exogenous means external factor apply important role in inducing eczema. Whereas endogenous eczema, the internal factor including genetic factor apply important role in inducing eczema. In exogenous, if you take care of the causative agent or what is causing the eczema, then you can get rid of the eczema. Whereas in endogenous eczema, it is not like that. Because internal factors play a role. You can take care of a triggering factors to keep the eczema under control. These eczemas are known to relapse, unlike exogenous eczemas. Exogenous eczemas include allergic contact eczema. That means some external agent in the form of either solid or liquid or gas come in contact with the skin and cause an allergy. Here the allergy play important role. The another example of exogenous eczema is irritant eczema. Here excessive concentration of that agent play a role, unlike allergy. Like that, one more example is infective eczema. Here, the infection causes allergy and redness of the skin. Some of the examples for endogenous eczemas are atopic dermatitis, or also known as atopic eczema. Here, the sensitivity of the skin plays an important role, which is inborn or genetically determined. So, there are so many triggering factors. If you take care of the triggering factor, you can keep this eczema under control. But you cannot cure the eczema. It is known to relapse. The other example for endogenous eczemas are seborrheic eczema, palm pollix, that is dyssidrotic eczema affecting the palms and soles, nummular eczema, asketotic eczema, gravitational eczema. These are the example for the endogenous eczema. So today I have told you what is eczema and what are the types of eczema. Stay tuned to my channel. Thank you.